And we're back! I missed the
Dire
first
team
part of
pick.
the picks, but let's just ignore that. So I can go for the Slaughter Lifestealer combo, banning the Meepo Visage here. So it will be a Lizard IO now. Some nice IO picks that aren't really metas, like CK, Timbersaw even. I've seen mid player play Timbersaw quite a bit. Okay, so they picked a Bane for the Lifestealer Enrage for the lockdown. They get the Mirana.
10 seconds remaining.
I'll also actually use their camera. It'll be a
remaining.
Bit easier to commentate alone.
Reserve time.
So something to counter the Shadow Demon Mirana's. It's always a hard game with those two supports. Skype sounds as well. There we go, the IO Timbersaw. Like I mentioned, it's a pretty good combo with
10 seconds
all
remaining.
The damage reduction of the overcharge with the reactive armor.
5 seconds remaining.
But they have like a lot of nukes. They have the Slaughter Lifestealer with the Mirana when he gets his Agnims. And I'll try not to forget my overlay now.
Remaining.
Okay, so they ban the Ursa.
Reserve time. Dire team pick.
An interesting ban.
Shadow Fiend.
Okay, so
Radiant
that's the SF for the mid.
Remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Nice support here is the Weaver, but okay, the OD. Weaver is pretty good against the IO. The armor reduction against the axe and the Timbersaw. Yeah, I guess the Bane is the main reason they didn't went back for the Weaver. Game starts with a pause. Tactical pause. Oh, whatever, I'll just use my camera. I have to learn anyway. Someone's gonna be slender on the axe, pain on the timber saw, on the bane, lizard on the IO, and mid player on the SF. On their team, it's the Mirana with Nowhere Free, TJ on the Life Stealer, Flash on the Shadow Demon, El Patron on the OD, and Rot on the Slardar. They haven't bought any items yet because they paused straight away. Fucking overlay, sorry. Okay, that's the start of the game. Is that going for the raid band? Fairy fire. Pain actually TPing to the mid lane to place a ward here. Pretty straightforward. Looks like he's going to ward, place two wards before the game starts. Maybe place one. Yeah, okay. So it's actually going to be Lifestealer top. He'll actually get spotted out because of this ward. He actually blocked the camp.
It
looks like they're moving the lanes around. I don't really know. They are contesting the rune with the disruption arrow combo. They'll actually miss. And looks like that's it for contesting the rune.
The battle begins.
Okay, so it's the SF mid with two shared tangos. A nice mid ward versus the OD. It should be a pretty even lane. Let's put up the last hits. Axe will get spotted out by the ward top. So it's the solo Axe versus the Lifestealer against the Timber Saw bottom.
Not for you.
Looks like they're gonna be focusing a lot on mid this game. So it's three or two versus three mid with the lizard. He actually went for the bottle first. Did he try to stack this or did he fail? I don't know, but it didn't work. So they actually try laning mid. Probably until SF gets around 15 Necromasteries. They're actually already doing a wraparound with Mirana, Shadow Demon on the axe. But I guess he'll will. Yep, he'll hit a creep. He missed another combo. So there's three heroes top for nothing. And they'll probably go straight back to mid and try the same combo again there. The problem with this roaming duo is like, if they don't get any early kills, it's so hard to catch up. That's why the IO pick with the overcharge and the tether could actually help them a lot to try and negotiate some of the damage. I think first bot will probably take a while until they maybe latch their first combo. Like a bad outplay, but for the rest, I don't think it should be coming this early. Maybe Axe gets caught here. Nope, he saw. He tried to go for the rune. Just a random arrow gets spotted out by the ward. Meanwhile, Lizard helping out Timber.
Of fear.
So it's a pretty even lane, 11-8. This... Again, the Mirana. It's really bad positioning. Axe just turning on them with illusions. Shadow Demon created. But that's going to be first blood with Axe, with Mirana as the combo, and he didn't even fire an arrow. Meanwhile, mid, gonna get contested a bit. So he gets sleeped. He actually tries saving himself, but don't do that. Yeah, he just turned. And he gets saved by lizards. They turn on him with the slow race or the far race. Meanwhile, Timber has 9 reactive stacks. Just making Slaughter's life a pain now. Oh, they're already doing Ancients. That's 3 minutes. It's really, really early, but with the IO, I guess you can. Getting a lot of experience. Level 4. Axe making this Lifestealer's life a pain. They've got 2 pretty tanky cores, so I don't know what the idea behind this draft is. Probably with Azef going into a more carry build. Axe SD doing a lot of damage. Mirana gets scouted out. Probably use his Nightmare and his Brain Sap. Okay. But yeah, I guess he had Leap. Didn't want to waste any mana on it. Meanwhile, Lizard doing some stacking work. Let's see if his double stack works here. It should. Yep, he just double stacked. Axe getting another call. Here, the OD almost getting a kill. Oh, he actually got the kills with Disruptor Illusions. This game is gonna be a lot more fast-paced than the previous one. And they're constantly putting 3 heroes mid with the Shadow Demon Mirana combo. Well, Timber's getting so much form. He's already got 33 CS. You're gonna take the stacks here. I'll probably be close to level 6 for the Azef when he finishes them. Yep. Okay, actually, it's their first time they hit the combo, but Lizard's coming in. Going on the... yep, that's the dead Shadow Demon. Slender gonna turn on the Mirana as well. Space created, missed arrow. Did it hit a creep? Nope. So that's pretty good early game from AK.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Timbersaw going for the soul ring. Just getting a lot of creeps here. 43. Azef with the stacks. Also getting a lot of levels here. See net worth, they're a bit ahead. Experience should be more, a 0.5k experience ahead, and they can just play the farm game. Cause yeah, Lizard just keeps sealing them up. Because IO with his bottle, spawning every 2 minutes. He even goes to base, Oh, they even use the shrine here in the base. And they even have this shrine open as well, so. Well, Timber making this Slardar's life pain. Yep, it just backs away. Guess he's creeps. That's a dead Slardar. Nice position from Bane. Probably knowing that he should or was gonna run there. Mirana not doing so much.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant structures.
He's already creep skipping, getting first tower here. The wages of fear. Seth just raising every creep wave to get every creep. Getting healed by Lizard here. They're actually gonna try and go on the Timber Saw. They can just chain summon, yep. And that's a dead Timber. Slander stole 1k from his Blink Dagger. Not getting too much, yes, only 42. Yeah, he'll just TP out, no problem. Did they use this? No, they didn't use the shrine yet. Suppose they just has the bottle. They're just gonna keep farming this Zef until it's a friggin' beast. Already doing ancients again. Getting a lot of XP there. You know, Timble's also level 9 already. I guess it's even higher than the SF, yeah. He's sharing a lot of XP with the IO. And he's gonna get like level 6 pretty early on his IO. He's already pretty far
Radiant's
ahead, only
tower is under attack.
A bit of XP. Meanwhile, they're trying to initiate on the axe again.
Radiant's
with the
bottom
arrow
tower
combo.
Is under attack.
Yes. Now it hits, but yeah, Lizard's there to save the day.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
Just shooing them away. The little cat lady. A Phoenix Grip actually makes a dead Odie. They shouldn't be able to get anyone on this. They don't. But Timber's coming in from behind. Mirana has no leap.
Radiant's middle tower.
So he should be dead. Yep, that's a dead Mirana. That's mid tower.
Radiant structures are fortified.
And this Lifestealer has his armlet. Timber doing a lot of work on him. But once he's got his 20 reactive armor stacks up, you think, yeah, he's doing a lot of damage, but he actually isn't anymore. Again, doing all these ancients. Look like this Gambus really benefiting this lineup with the IO Shadow Fiend. Just getting a lot of XP.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
IO level 6 already. Just 11 minutes. Slaughter actually already has his blink. He skipped. Oh, he didn't skip. He got his wrinkles. His blink. He's in pretty good shape.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Well, Timber going to pressure top bot tower a bit. But you'll have to watch out for the OD arrow or the Shadow Demon arrow. The synergy of their lineup is really well, like they can Shadow Demon Disrupt into Slaughter Crush, Arrow, OD, Imprisonment into Crush with the Lifestealer Bomb. But let's see how their teamwork is. First reveal of the Blink Dagger, I think. Drutico on the IO. Yeah, that's set at IO. X manages to blink away. Until I'll probably try start pushing this tower a lot more. Timber shooing the cat lady away. He's actually going for the Aethos build on OD. It's good to keep the Timber and Axe in place. Mirana. Oh, yep. Mirana hasn't ulted yet, so it's probably time. Or right now, he should use it. Especially when they're coming to smoke. Brana will probably use a shrine now, I guess. There is no way they can defend this tower. He even arrowed the creep. That was a bit weird. I think he wanted to arrow his timber, but yeah. So then Mirana ulted. Shadow Demon using his disruption into the crush. But they're gonna start fighting without their OD here. So bad positioning from OD. Their whole team getting caught out. Life Sealer should be dead. Even Fiend's Grip for it. There comes OD with the Haste Rune running in. He actually misses every single person there with his arrow. And this SF, yeah, it's a friggin' beast. Let's check his net worth. 8.7k on the SF already. A lot of those ancient creeps paying off. Especially with the levels, level 12 already. That was a really bad place to fight from Dubai there.
Radiant's top tower has fallen.
Like their OD wasn't there and they Mirana ulted and initiated. Without a blink crush and... Yeah, they blink crushed, but they missed the infest. Mirana's just throwing arrows, not doing anything. While they are starting to get to Roshan. Okay, they're actually gonna try to fight this with Swagger coming back in. Mirana, what is he doing? He even arrowed an ancient creep here. Not the best Mirana plays I've seen. Actually scan? The Dire scans? This worked. It's a really good one with the smoke usage. It should reveal everything. Ooh, acts like. Do they have detection yet? Yeah, access dust.
Dire's middle tower.
So they will probably try to initiate with when Mirana's ult is up. Or try to do something. Yep, they use Mirana ult. But there's a sentry here, Axe calls. He should have used his dust. But he doesn't. He missed his chop. Well, Bane's Fiend Grip gets cancelled. On the OT, misses, even misses his ultimate. On the Shadow Fiend. And they should be able to just get the Roshan. While Timber's distracting them here. Chasing on. Nope, he stops chasing.
I hit Roshan with my eyes closed.
Mirana even erring Roshan to help them. And with Slaughter coming back up, but he shouldn't have TP. Oh, he did. He does. They just give up Roshan. They don't want to throw any lead away. He's going to deward. Yeah. quelling, but it always helps.
Ready warning.
Okay, smoke up. Sara actually getting scouted out with his ward here. They all go uphill, smoke breaks. Oh, that's a really nice call. With the least of vision he had her. Oh, Bane cancelled his nightmare on OD, I think. As if I should get arrowed. Yeah, they shouldn't be able to defend this. They'll just get, yeah. Lifestealer even has to buy back the Fest and the Slaughter. If he gets a big crush, yeah, I guess a three-man crush into Infest Bomb. Oh, what? Yep. That was the best they could get out of that fight with the Infest into three-man crush. And they still got team wide because of the nice relocate from Lizard. Actually relocating in from Fountain to Heedle. And they lose 5 men, they lose Roche, they lost their lives. 7.5k in experience and 7.5k in net worth. Zephyr King 12k, Timber 8k, and OT with a miserly 7k. Timber gets a nice region rune. As I felt ready with the ring a kill out Dragonlance Mantat in 19 minutes and 3k in the bank. Weird, they base down with the Aegis on the Shadow Fence. Just looked out like they will just try and pressure the bottom tower. Lizard coming in with the balls. Actually not scouting out the Shadow Demon. He actually blocked him? But looks like he just wants to. Oh, he still goes for the call. Bane saving his fence grip, using it on the Lifestealer. Where's your detection? Mirana here is actually manning up. Yeah, he'll probably even get caught by the Timber, chaining and finishing him. Meanwhile, there's still fighting going on here with the Slaughter. But they're getting ahead by a lot. They're already 12,500 in experience or in net worth, and the same in experience. They'll get their mid tower. Bottom tower is gone, so they'll get their mid tower. Get the shrines. Oh, Lysila dodging that call, but Timber's going in. Actually cancel his DP there. Has fallen. Yeah, it's not looking good. It's not looking good for them here. They're pinned high ground. Zef just farming away. Zef going for the Scotty pickup. Radiant's top tower has probably fallen. With the ultimate orb and the point booster. SF's a freaking beast. He's dealing 230 a pop. The shrine just melts. Still has his Aegis, so they can just do whatever they want. Save for this Timbu with 12 Bloodstone charges. Already got the plate mail, going for the Lotus Orb. Which is a nice way to reflect some of the spells, like
Shadows take us.
Disruption, maybe purge the Corrosive. It's two shrines gone, 300 gold for both of them. Everything's looking good so far. Dubai just doing the same as last game, trying to split push, take them away from their base, but they will trade Rex for a top tower any day. So they start pressuring it now. OD actually has no TP again. So it's again, they can defend this so far. That's what they probably say now, because they just keep hacking at the barracks. Sorry coming in with a crush, but he actually kills himself. And Lifestealer probably. I would just call GG. Yeah, okay, they actually get a turnaround here with the buyback of the OD. Ag just pinning away, and Timber gets a pullout kill there. Yeah, it's like high ground is their hardest thing to do. Like last game, they actually went high ground, they threw a bit. And actually got Dubai to come back a bit.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
They lost 8 SF died twice there in that fight. And they only got OD buyback out of it. A 10 kill streak for the OD. It's 1.1k cash in the bank. It went for a 4 staff. Into a PKB. Okay. Timber still going for the Lotus Orb. Mirvana with Tom here. Yeah, he has not done too much this game. Let's check the Vision game out. Dire actually got some pretty deep wards here. They see a lot of them. While Radiant only has a few defensive wards around here. So that's when they're smoking up. Actually initiate on the Lifestealer here. Slaughter with a crush. Actually killing the Zeph with a big ult here. X tanking all the damage, but they are actually not killing anyone. But they turn it around with Zeph's massive damage output. OD just teleporting out here. And they go straight for mid. Try to force a buyback out of Shadow Demon or Mirana. They will probably let Shadow Demon buyback first, because Mirana is racking 2k gold for the Agnums. Shadow Demon buys back. SF actually going just walked high ground here.
Middle tower is under attack.
And they turn around on the Lifestealer with the call. They save him. They actually kill the Axe. A bit miscommunication here leads to a TP from Lizard or a relocate. Let's see how Lizard tries to save himself. Yep, and that's a dead lizard as well. Again! A buyback from the Shadow Demon, they hold their base, so... it's not over yet. Except for wrecking 18k gold. But when he gets the BKB... OD won't have to do so much to him anymore. Do they see him? Yeah, they see him. They're actually chasing the illusion. Shadows take us. Actually, even commit Mirana ultimate for it. Okay, they. Yeah, the illusion's dead, boys. That's the vision game. They only had this ward, and this ward fucked them pretty hard. Meanwhile, Timber and Azef still farming up. Lizard with the mech, the boots, the urn. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Actually, going to Glimmer Cape with the cloak. Yeah, okay. Next fight going to be pretty important, because if OD fights without his BKB, or SF without his BKB, they will just melt. Again, Rose being up, another important aspect. That's why they're a bit hesitant. Turn become to tank up with his reactive armor. And what other? Yeah, they're. Probably discussing to try and defend this. Oh, Lizard. Lizard got arrowed. But they paid a price. They got the IO. They kill the Lifestealer. For poor little Lizard. Timber saw using his chains. X. Oh. Okay, still got taunted. And they killed 3-4 our little ball with Lizard. And they lose Rose as well. Odie has his BKB now, that's why he didn't go to the fight, but they still lose 3 people, so that's really bad team play there. You should just wait it or go S5, or just, yeah. That's just some game losing stuff there. I don't know if it's the Odie's fault or just really bad communication from the team. You should have expected more from a top 4 team here. Also going for the PKP. Azef completed his, still with the 10 seconds on it. OD also 10 seconds on his BKB. And they can just assault high ground now with the Manta style illusions. And the Aegis. Timber going for the Lincolns. Lincolns and the Lotus Orb, so very defensive items for him. But what does he need? He has 30 Bloodstone charges. He's only died once this game. Well, OT teleporting in. These illusions doing more work than any player out than their team. Slara's position for the crush. He doesn't want to go on the Timber, but probably the IO or the Pain here. But they're positioned pretty well. But they still get blown up. But that's the problem. Like, all they can do is kill the IO. You have to buy back the Slaughter. Their OD dies. You will have to buy back. He will have to buy back. Odie buys back. And that's 3 buybacks just to defend. And they don't, and they still lose their racks here. And SFs. Yeah, just some big commitments to keep their racks. There will always be something worse. 3 buybacks used just to get 3 kills. They're like worth half the gold, so. Everything's still going in the way of 8k? Everyone on their team is going for a BKB. Slaughter's for a BKB. OD going for a BKB. And Lifestealer. Yeah, he's just is a BKB, so 3 BKBs picked up. Let's see where this Timber is going. Yeah, he'll actually spot out Slaughter there. But he's got a Lincolns, he's got a Lotus Orb. X calls them. He even has to double chop. Wow, and another missed arrow from Mirana. X with the call! Yeah, he got him. He killed him. He missed his chop, but it doesn't matter. Their life is over. Mirana even went for the gem here, gem into Maelstrom. So a Mirana build. Looks like he's lost in time with his Mirana here. He manages to hit arrow, but what will it do? They don't have any buyback on the three heroes. He ults, but he ults just to get an arrow out that doesn't connect. They'll probably get. Yep, they will get megas out of this. Another arrow not doing anything. X being positioned, we'll just blink on the first guy he sees. And they're just going to dead ball on this Rex. Bane actually raping this Slice Stealer. With a nice chain, with the Fiend Grip into the call. They buy back the Slice Stealer. I don't even want to see the Nedgroff. 20k in front. Oh! Bane even died there. And they're turning it. With the BKBs all popped. X might get caught with the imprisonment here. It did. Into the Slaughter Crush. Well timed. And they kill him off. Meanwhile, Lizard actually died here. And they don't get the megas, but Roshan will be up pretty soon, few minutes, and then they'll just deadball for the Rex, get megas. Timber going for the Agnums too.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
And it's the first time in such a long time they actually get the tower. Dire's and they push.
Middle tower has fallen.
Haha, with the little cheeky Lotus Orb there. I think I even saw the imprisonment. Getting casted.
Dire's middle tower.
Just these disruptions.
Dire's structures are fortified.
They actually managed to get the tower.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
But that will probably be it, because they have to run back to their base, because it's getting shredded to bits. Massive creep wave here. Lizard actually relocating in. And he forgot to take someone. What? He even cancelled his TP himself. What is this guy doing? He's just creating space for everyone. That was a pretty weird play there. What the? Did he just forget to tether someone? I don't know. Was it to create space? Lizard just a spaceman. Did he try to? What? I still don't get this play. You can use Relocate for it. Ocean timer, pretty low. They'll maybe try and just smoke, try to contest Roshan, but. And they'll just call it if they lose that fight. Lizard just going full Davi with his haste rune. Yeah, Lizard has to be careful. He Lizard probably scanned here as well. So that's the Roshan. How long will the respawn be? It's a really short respawn. So they can just farm their last items. And Zef actually went. He didn't save his buyback, so they're pretty confident on winning the game right now, but without Roshan, I think. He got his Lincolns as well. It's a pretty interesting build. They're already having trouble defending against super creeps here. Simpsons lost a game where they actually went versus Megas. They didn't have the really good draft to deal with them. They actually don't have so much AoE. Bane's getting ready to force stuff. And Roshan is up, so they'll probably head there from here to Roshan. They'll just push the wave with the Manta Illusions. Yep, they're moving towards the Roshan pit. Let's see what the other team does. In desperation, they get some wards, they get Mirwana with the Mjolnir. He's already getting ready to defend against the Megas with the right click build. And it's weird they... Let's check their vision out. Yeah, they don't have any clue where they are. Yeah, it's some weird... I guess I'll just try to defend high ground. But it'll still be really hard against that lineup. They can just plow through, get the Rex, get the Megas. They pop the defensive. Mirwana ult, they don't do anything with it. Like, Mirwana's the one frontline here, it's really weird. They will just wait till it's over. Pop the Lincolns on the SF and just hit their axe. Raise the. Yeah. Oh, he actually saved himself with that call. SF just goes in, BKB. Tries hitting some Rex, but Slaughter actually caught Bane here. Bane and Io, the support duo. The supports are getting dropped. But Tero D is dead, he has no buyback. And a big goal from Axe, getting shredding them to pieces. Slaughter coming in. Lifestealer killing off the Izef as Aegis. And they will just probably wreck them now. I actually missed his leap. He didn't get out, he didn't disjoint the attack. This should just be GG. Or maybe give him a rampage, who knows? Give them a present for Christmas. Come on, get that rampage. Manta dodges the arrow. And he gets his rampage. Rampage. They still don't call it. It's a massive piece of an SF. And they call it GG. 8K, take the game. Middle tower is under attack. They take the best of three. Dire victory. So that's it for these games. So they actually take the series 2-0. Pretty confident run. Pretty hard time going high ground. Sometimes they threw a little bit, but in the end, the SF was just too much to deal with. I hope you had a good time. See you later.